All right, so here I am again with another review, and this time it's a review for Sin City, A Dame to Kill For, directed by Robert Rodriguez and starring basically almost everyone in the friggin' universe, man. Now, I am a huge fan of the first Sin City. I saw the first Sin City, I was like 11. I saw it literally right when it came out for rental. And I, first of all, I was shocked by it, you know, but at the same time, I really, really liked it. You know, it was like the first time I had ever been transported into the comic book world, because I had seen other adaptations of like graphic novels and comic books and so forth. This is the first time where it was like the dialogue, the language, the world, everything was taken from the Sin City graphic novels and onto the big screen. You know what I mean? You know, it also had some really cool stories to back it up, and it was just crazy how faithful it was to the Sin City comic book. So, that being said, you know, this time around, I had high expectations for it, and, you know, Sin City was, like, the first movie where I was like, Robert Rodriguez can make a generally good movie, because I always saw Robert Rodriguez's movies, the rest of them being just cheap, dumb, fun movies, you know what I mean? But I was kind of hoping he'd go back to just making something legitimately good, you know what I mean? And that's definitely the case with Sin City, Dame to Kill For, because even though Dame to Kill For isn't as good as the first Sin City, it's still a pretty damn good movie. And so the story of, like, Dame to Kill For is that it's basically what the first Sin City was, which is a series of, like, short stories that talk about many of the characters. And, you know, got one story, it's got just Gordon-Levitt, who's this, like, gambler who gets into some kind of trouble, that's all I'll say. And then you got, like, the story with Nancy Callahan, her dealing with Hardigan's death, and the other one is the Dame to Kill For storyline between Dwight and Ava Lord, that's all I'll say. And, you know, and much like the first Sin City, it all comes together and all works, like, really, really well, you know what I mean? So, first of all, the great things about this movie is, first of all, the looks. This looks great. It's still visually stunning. It looks like, you know, the Sin City graphic novels have been, and that's fantastic, you know what I mean? And the acting is really good. I mean, you know, Joseph Gordon-Levitt was really good in the movie. I liked, his story was probably my favorite story of the entire film. Jessica Alba as Nancy was actually pretty good. Like, it's a surprise for me to say Jessica Alba's good, because I don't think she's a good actress, and I kind of thought she was a little miscast in the first Sin City, but this one, she's pretty good in this movie, you know what I mean? And I like where they went with her character. Mickey Rourke as Marv. Mickey Rourke is awesome as Marv, you know what I mean? He's so funny. He loves to get himself in some kind of trouble, and it's awesome, you know what I mean? And Mickey Rourke will always kick ass as playing Marv. Josh Brolin was good as Dwight, though. In fact, I feel like Josh Brolin did a better job than Clive Owen, because Josh Brolin's Dwight is like someone, you know, you can get behind with, you know what I mean? Someone you could totally follow, you know what I mean? And I felt with Clive Owen's Dwight, I thought he was cool, but I just kind of felt like Josh Brolin did a little bit better, you know what I mean? And Eva Green steals a show as Ava Lord. She is incredible in this movie, you know what I mean? But sort of my main problems with this movie is the fact that during the Damien Kilford storyline, you've got the subplot between Christopher Maloney and Jeremy Piven, and it slowed the movie down for me, you know what I mean? I kind of felt like it totally was unnecessary, and I kind of felt like if you'd taken that out of the movie, then, you know, the movie would have run a little bit more better, you know what I mean? The pacing would have been a little bit better. And just also the fact that this movie ended too abruptly, I think. You know, the way things end concluded, I was just like, that's it? You know what I mean? I was left a little underwhelmed by that, you know what I mean? And the movie's also kind of a little too short. It's like an hour and 42 minutes in. The first Sin City, I mean, it's like 2 hours, 2.5 hours if you get the director's cut. But here it's like an hour and 42 minutes in. I can't help but feel like a lot of stuff was cut out. And, you know, I kind of hope that on the Blu-ray, Robert Rodriguez does, like, an extended cut like he did with the first Sin City. But other than that, Sin City, Dame to Kill For is a really, really good movie. If you're a fan of the first Sin City, you'll like it. If you're a Sin City fan, then you've probably seen it. If you haven't, check it out. If you're a Robert Rodriguez fan, you'll enjoy it. And so with that being said, I'm going to give Sin City, Dame to Kill For a B. I really liked it. I really enjoyed it. And yeah, that's my 2 cents on Dame to Kill For.